Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get? We fought a Cold War for 40 years against governments that forced all persons subject to their authority to carry government-issued identification cards. Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get? Where are your papers? Is a command that strikes at the core of freedom of movement and the right to privacy in a free society. Surely there are less intrusive ways to keep track of lawful and unlawful immigrants without assaulting the fundamental rights of us all. Where will this end? The proposed ID cards that the government is now considering are biometric. Thus, the police can swipe the card and learn much about the bearer's medical, legal, and travel history, none of which may lawfully be made available to the government absent the consent of the owner of the card or absent a warrant issued by a federal judge based upon probable cause of crime. Freedom needs breathing room. Explaining or justifying one's presence to agents of the government stifles that breathing room and leads to totalitarianism. Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get? I was not surprised, but I was scandalized when I read just this morning Senator Lindsey Graham, Republican of South Carolina, Senator Charles Schumer, Democrat of New York, were meeting with the president in order to formulate legislation that would require every person in the United States of America who is employed to carry a biometric identification card with them, something even the British government rejected in the past 10 years. Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get? Meeting with the president in order to formulate legislation that would require every person in the United States of America who is employed to carry a biometric identification card with them. Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get?
The water in Amesbury is supposed to have fluoride in it, but Rob Damaris has been concerned for years about what's in the supply he gets from China. The residue you see here is what won't dissolve when he puts the fluoride powder in the water.
What is that?
We don't know.
You have no idea what's in there?
I don't know what it is. It's not soluble. And it doesn't appear to be sodium fluoride, so we're not quite sure what it is.
Damaris says the residue clogs his machines and makes it difficult to get a consistent mix.
For almost a year, these fluoride pumps in Amesbury have been off, and the water department says they'll stay off until they can figure out what's in the fluoride.
The Department of Public Health says more than 650,000 customers in 44 communities are getting the product in question, and only Amesbury has temporarily stopped using it.
But despite those concerns, we want to be clear. Both state and federal health officials tell Team 5 Investigates Chinese fluoride is safe.
The New York company which supplies the fluoride in question says it is certified by the National Sanitation Foundation, which assures the quality of the product. And despite 1,000 complaints, the Centers for Disease Control also says it's safe, although testing continues to determine the precise composition of the residue.
They should test it to make sure that what they're putting in is safe for us to drink.
Paul Stewart lives in Newburyport and believes he has a right to know exactly what's in his water.
On the same day that I read the story about the fluoride coming from China, I also read stories about the melamine that was being contaminated in the milk products coming from China, that Abercrombie and Fitch actually pulled some of their jewelry off the shelves because it was contaminated with cadmium coming from China. And then we had another story about more lead in kids' toys coming from China.
Since 2007, most of the sodium fluoride has also been imported from China because it's the least expensive on the market.
I don't think that when it comes to something that I ingest every day, the lowest bidder is good enough.
I'd like to be able to add it in, worry-free.
Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get?
Achtung, Achtung! Fernsehsender Paul Nipko. Wir grüßen alle Volksgenossen und Volksgenossinnen in den Fernsehstuben Groß-Berlin mit dem deutschen Gruß Heil Hitler.
Hi, I'm Linda Douglas. I'm the Communications Director for the White House Office of Health Reform. And one of my jobs is to keep track of all the disinformation that's out there about health insurance reform. And there are a lot of very deceiving headlines out there right now.
I am not aware of any precedent for a president asking American citizens to report their fellow citizens to the White House for pure political speech that is deemed fishy.
Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, what?
Are you an enemy of the state? Did you send an email critical of health care? Did you tell your neighbor that health care plan was not for you, that you had concerns about it? You know, you should really send that information to the White House so they can collect that data.
And unfortunately, it's a pattern of intimidation we've seen by folks here in Washington who don't want people to speak up about defects and problems they see in the proposals that are coming from Capitol Hill.
You get an email from your neighbor and you're not, it doesn't sound right, send it to the White House. You know, people I think all across America are going to say, is this 1984? What's happening here? Is Big Brother watching?
Where does this go? Is this counter intelligence programs
sure.
that we had in the 60s under J. Edgar Hoover?
You don't have to be a conspiracy theorist to see the potential for serious abuse.
Well, is there a White House watch list that you know of at this point, Senator Cornyn? What have they said that they're going to do with these names? Are they passing them on to the FBI, the Secret Service?
Cops is filmed on location with the men and women of law enforcement. All suspects are innocent until proven guilty in a court of law.
So it's very important for you to have the facts. The clip that you just saw is available on www.whitehouse.gov.
Zum Ausgang des Abends, mach Musik. Auf Wiedersehen bei der nächsten Sendung. Heil Hitler!
Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get?
State lawmakers will start debating budget cuts tomorrow in Columbia. For the first time in state history, programs for children and adults with disabilities and special needs could be eliminated to save money. Dozens of families from the upstate who rely on these services will be heading to the state house tomorrow to try and convince lawmakers to reconsider.
They have children with special needs and disabilities, a life most could never understand.
My child doesn't have a voice. I'm her voice. We are our children's voices.
Families in these situations don't have a lot of options. Most all of the help they get comes from the state.
This program has helped us out tremendously. My sister is 36 years old. She's mentally retarded, autistic.
The Charles Lee Center in Spartanburg is a way of life more than 500 families depend on. They can go to work knowing loved ones are safe. Most of all, they're happy. Everyone here feels like family. A family that could soon be left to fend for itself if a proposed $47 million budget cut to the Department of Disabilities and Special Needs gets final approval. The cuts would eliminate day service programs across the state and in-home respite care. The list goes on and on.
We're scared.
Yeah, very frightened.
This is all we have.
Families say this is the cruelest cut of all because it affects our most fragile. Online, families are mobilizing support. More than 3,000 people have joined the Stop South Carolina Budget Cuts That Affect Disabled and the Shame on You South Carolina campaign.
If this were to be discontinued, then of course, I mean, it seems as though that would be a part of life. It's just in for her and a lot of other families.
In less than 24 hours, these families will crowd the state house for the second time in 2 weeks, taking a stand for the estimated 30,000 that could lose crucial services and programs this summer.
There is $200 million in federal stimulus money that could reverse some of the budget cuts, but final approval hasn't been given yet, and that will have to come from federal lawmakers. There are no guarantees, and that's why these families say they have to keep pressure on state lawmakers.
Wow. How much more un-American can the American government get?